Ah, chocolate. Delicious and full of math. That's right, I said math. Today, we get to go behind the scenes of an actual chocolate factory and see how they use math every single day. Let's get into it.
Doodly-doodle, doodly-doodles and digits. Area, symmetry, fractions too. It's all here for you.
My name is Nick Trifilis. Welcome to the Anthony Thomas Candy Company. I am fifth generation of our family-owned company, and I am the National Sales and Marketing Manager. We use math every single day here at Anthony Thomas. I personally keep my phone with me at all times. I use the calculator throughout the day. My grandfather actually keeps an old-fashioned calculator about this big in his pocket, and we use it to be able to finalize how many numbers we need of each. For instance, when we're making candy bars, we will need to know how many wrappers we're using for that day and make sure we have enough in our inventory. So what we will do is we will take from our existing inventory minus the number that we need and see what is left so we can keep for leftover production and for the future as well. We have a special team that formulates our recipes and makes sure we have everything written down to a fine point. What they do is make sure that we have enough sugar, milk, chocolate, whatever it is for each product, and we'll be able to weigh it out. So for instance, we will know that our English toffee is 50%, or one half of it is butter. So we can find out how many pieces of candy we made that day. What we do takes a little bit of math. We are able to set our machines to run a certain amount of molds a minute. What a mold is the actual tray that takes the candy from start to finish. So we know there'll be 12 molds a minute. Each mold holds 42 pieces. So what we can do is we can take the 12 molds a minute times 42 pieces, and then we're running an 8-hour shift. So we know to times that by 60 to get it in hours. So 12 times the 42 gets you the total amount in a minute. Times 60 gets you how much you need in an hour, and then we're open 8 hours a day for just one shift. So that would be then times 8. So that would give us how many pieces we made that day. For instance, with Buckeyes, we make 147,000 Buckeyes in 8 hours. We have a lot of equipment that can weigh out each of our candy bars. We have three different size options that we offer here at Anthony Thomas: a 1 ounce, a 1.5 ounce, and a 3.5 ounce. We need to double check though and weigh the candies as well and make sure that they are the appropriate weights. So there'll be a certain amount of grams we are looking for, and we'll use a scale to see how heavy the bars are to check and make sure the machines are running them at the right weight. 4 times a year here at Anthony Thomas, we have to add up all of our inventory. What that means is we need to know how much money we have invested here in our company in wrappers, chocolate, packaging. Every material we have has to be added up. So we will go around and see how many gold 16-ounce boxes we have. And if we have 30 16-ounce gold boxes, we will mark that down, put it in our system, and we'll have to line everything up, each item, and then times it by what the cost was to us.
Quick questions at a chocolate factory. What does a typical day look like at a chocolate factory?
A typical day at Anthony Thomas starts right at 6 in the morning in our kitchen. So we're open from 6 until 1 at night. So we're open very late. A typical morning, we'll start with making the candies. We go up there and check each piece as they come out in the beginning to make sure that the candies are coming out exactly the way we like them. And a very important step is weighing the candy, making sure that it is the exact weight for what we need for each box. Because if it is too light or too heavy, the box will not be where it was supposed to. Another major step of our mornings is being able to make sure that everyone was here on time and that we have everything we need for that production day. Again, that's going through our inventory and seeing how much we have of each item. And sometimes you have inventory in multiple spots of the factory, so you will have to add up all the inventory in different parts. We may have some wrappers in our kitchen, we may have some downstairs in our warehouse, and we may have some in the office. So you'll need to add those three numbers up to find out, oh, we have 100 wrappers in total.
How do you determine the price of your chocolate?
There's a lot of factors that go into determining the price of a box of candy. Right now, a standard box of candy at Anthony Thomas is around $22.95 for a pound. You need to take into account a lot of factors when coming into price. Not only do you need to know the price of each individual ingredients, but you need to know what percent you're using those. Again, for the English toffee, we know that it's 50% butter. So when we're coming up with the English toffee price, we need to use a fraction of what we paid for the butter and know how much is going into the toffee. You also have to add in the cost of labor, the cost of storage, the cost of packaging, transportation to our stores, and the employee wages at our stores. So there's a lot of different factors that go into pricing a box of candy. I bet you never knew that.
How important is it to be precise?
It is so important to be precise when you're creating chocolates because you want every piece to taste the exact same. You don't want to have a lot of variety in how the candies are tasting, or else people won't want to buy them. If they know they love your piece, they want a milk chocolate, buttercream, they want it to be the same every time. That's why it is so important to measure out and be precise with all of your ingredients so that you get full flavor in every bite and that it always tastes the same. And we use fractions and we use lots of math in our recipes to be able to create each piece.
Is it important to show your thinking?
It is very important for us to keep track of how much we've made a day or how much we have left. So what we'll do is we will write down on a piece of paper how many batches we've made. For instance, if we're gonna make 20 batches of buttercreams, we will make sure to not make a notch for each one so then we can minus and not make too much because we do not wanna waste any product here and be wasteful. So what we will do is if we have 20 and by lunch there's 9 notches, we'll minus 9 and know we have to make 11 more batches before the end of the day.
What tools do you use when doing math?
For math, my favorite is simple pen and pencil, but I do use my phone every day to calculate how many pieces we've made or how much more we have to go. But the best way for me is just simple writing down 10 times 5 or 16 times 7 and just doing it by hand, carrying the one and making sure I have everything I need written down. Upstairs in our factory, we use the metric system, so we're using grams. And we will weigh all of the boxes of candy depending on if it's a stock box, which is larger, about 6 pounds, or an individual 1 pound box, which you'll see in our stores. Even down to the bite-sized piece, we'll weigh it to make sure that each piece is where they need to be. So we probably have about 50 scales in our facility.
Did you enjoy math growing up?
I did enjoy math growing up. Believe it or not, I took calculus in high school. And I took math all throughout my 4 years of university.
What is your best piece of advice for math students?
My advice to you for math is that always try your hardest and always take your classes seriously. Don't be afraid to ask for help. And the best way to learn is to sometimes work with a buddy or a friend and do things together. Get together after school, work on it, or see where you can use math in your everyday life. From just tidying up your room and seeing how many toys you have, or from even realizing how many pieces of gum you have left. Math can be used every day. Chocolate is the best industry in the world. It truly is a sweet job. We have tours here at our facility in Central Columbus and are more than happy to welcome you, where then you can see the math in our daily work here in person. So please visit us and we look forward to meeting you.
Challenge problem, Chocolate Factory Edition. Anthony Thomas has a candy mold that has 8 rows with 5 candies in each row. How many candies will that mold make? Did you get it right? Find out more about Anthony Thomas chocolates and their tours here.